What do you think about this? Well, most certainly not a Windows 7 beta build, but rather a mod called Project Blackcomb 2. And I can say this mod gives a good recreation of a Windows 7 beta experience. Straight into the desktop. The boot screen for it is using the normal Windows 7 version, but the actual setup is mirroring what's seen in Windows Vista, or more precisely, in Windows 7 Milestone 2 builds. It has no significant difference in the first phase and the second phase. But the OBE is using the classic theme. This is not a leftover from the creator or a bug, but this is actually happening in several Milestone 2 builds like 6568 and 6578. That's the real definition of, that's not a bug, it's a feature. After installing firmware tools and restarting the OS, we can see that the boot screen is still using the Windows 7 version, although I think Milestone 2 builds are using Windows Vista boot screen. The logon screen looks exactly like Windows Vista and 7 Milestone 2, with the only difference is the branding at the bottom of the screen, which displays Windows 7 Business as an early continuation of Windows Vista Business, which will later be known as Windows 7 Professional. Going to the desktop, you can see that the similarities between this mod and Windows 7 Milestone 2 build is noticeable, mainly because of the superbar. This look is close to build 6608, which we will discuss later on. Other than that, look at the gadgets. It still has its bar visible like in Windows Vista, unlike the actual beta builds, which don't have any. Looking back at the taskbar, the flyout for time and date, sound, and network don't have any additional graphic like in Vista and early Milestone 2 builds. You may notice this earlier that there is no quick launch in this mod because Windows 7 disabled it by default. There is no jump list too, as it will display the application's context menu when you right-click it. And there is no show desktop button at the rightmost of the taskbar. Moving to the start menu, comparing this start menu to the actual start menu in Milestone 2 builds, there are many additions in this mod start menu, such as the videos, games, downloads, search, devices and printers, and run. While in Milestone 2 builds, they still have Connect 2, which this mod doesn't have. The lock button in this mod is closer to what's in Windows 7, because this mod is based on Windows 7, but it's good to see a slight resemblance to what's seen in Milestone 2 builds. When using the search feature, the panel doesn't expand like in Milestone 2 builds, and the search the internet icon right there is using Internet Explorer icon rather than spyglass icon. Opening Windows Explorer, the look of the application is quite similar to its Milestone 2 version, despite some minor differences, mainly the command bar that doesn't have icon for its actions. Several special folders do have slight inaccuracies. The favorite folder adds the downloads folder, which Milestone 2 doesn't have. The libraries folder has this special banner seen in Windows 7. And one little detail that I'm eager to tell you, but many people may not even notice this. The search bar inside lacks one word in the string. The word is for, as in search libraries for. Well, apart from those, I am pretty much applauding this mod as it replaces all icons inside to be more accurate. And the time it takes to change it precisely is really consuming, so kudos to that. Next, control panel. I think control panel doesn't have any difference from Windows 7 except the left pane there. This applies to the category views too. There is one applet that I'm curious to open though. Change logon background, which is self-explanatory. This applet is taken from third party, obviously. There are heaps of options that you can choose from, but I don't think it works for me at this very moment. Looking at other applets such as performance informations and tools, parental controls, pen and touch, people near me, and troubleshooting. Welcome Center in this mod has been modified to use the Windows Vista banner, but the items inside hasn't been categorized like what in Windows Vista has. As for system applications, there are some, well, weird additions here, not gonna lie. This mod includes Internet Explorer version 11 rather than version 8 beta. Windows Media Player is version 12 with appearance resembling version 7. As for the coordinate of system applications, we got Calculator and Paint that was taken from its Milestone 2 version. WordPad, which is unchanged. And Notepad that surprisingly uses Notepad 3, a variant of Notepad. What about other applications? Command prompt just, well, being command prompt. Task manager has different color for its diagram. System restore, which displays different strings as you can see in the comparison. Help and support, that although it looks more like its original counterpart, it has a little bit messed up layout due to modifications of some sort. Accessibility applications like magnifier, an on-screen keyboard didn't have any change from Windows 7. I don't know yet as to why. Windows 7 or Vista applications that aren't in Milestone 2 are included, such as DVD Maker, Windows Media Center, Windows Calendar, and Windows Photo Gallery. Well, apart from that, some applications that do exist in Milestone 2 are included, well, a bit one-to-one port or has minor difference, such as, well, in Windows Mail, Windows Contacts, PowerShell, XPS Viewer, Sticky Notes, Math Input Panel, and Remote Desktop. Unlike Milestone 2, this mod includes games by default. For example, I tried Purple Place, the cake-making one that took me a short amount of time to finish. Right, speaking of customization and themes, we'll get to that by going to the context menu first. Comparing to what Milestone 2 has, it doesn't feature gadgets and display options, but rather adds command prompt as admin, search everything, and play dream scene options. Going to the personalize option, it points you towards the appearance and personalization applet category, rather than directly to the personalization applet. Well, nonetheless, you got a bunch of theme options that were taken from Windows 7, plus several additions, such as regional themes and minor Windows 7 beta theme styles. One theme that stood the most is Longhorn 5112 theme. I don't know why it was included, but the theme behavior is quite unique, with the task list and the taskbar stretching throughout. Window color customization is provided, as well as sound scheme and screensaver. Sample media are uniquely sorted to have both from Windows Vista and Windows 7. Not just one sample media, but I think all of them, starting from sample pictures, sample music, and sample video. As pretty as it looks, this mod is using Windows 7 as its base, well, as you know already. And thanks to Ryan and the team over Legacy Developer Network, the look and feel of Windows 7 Milestone 2 is brought to you this very moment. Alright, now time for the gadgets. Yes, it is Windows Vista's version with visible bar to store them, and it expands whenever you pull the gadget out of it. It pays differently than in Windows 7 Milestone 2, which doesn't have any bar visible, and it can be placed anywhere without any snapping involved. As for the gadget selection, let's just say there are too many of them in here. You can check out each one when you have the copy. Well, for me, I'm just gonna check some of them because I don't have the time to look for each one. Now, time to have some aero. Not 500 aero, just few aero. The old tab interface maintains the Windows Vista version that also exists in Windows 7. The Flip 3D is also staying in this mod, which makes it better. But that's not the case for Aero Snap. It doesn't have its glass animation over the simulated position. It just highlights the simulated area with semi-transparent blue overlay. Well, that's quite weird actually, but I think that was the behavior in Windows Basic theme. I don't know if I'm saying it correctly. And that's not all. There are several aero functions missing, like aero peak and aero shake. There is one missing application that may need an addition here. Windows Meeting Space. Because there are so many addition applications included in here, I don't know why Meeting Space is particularly missing. Perhaps Ryan and the team may be fixing this in the future, if possible. But hey, don't let my words stop you from checking out the mod yourself. You can check it out and feel the experience yourself. Because it's not that many mods that try to replicate the look and feel of a beta build or a development phase of Windows.